I'd like now to turn our attention to new friends of ours, new mission partners, David and Margarita Ely. So Joel's going to spotlight the two of us, or the three of us, and I'm going to welcome for everybody David and Margarita, who are going to tell us, first of all, where you're planning to head to. Well, tell us a little bit about where you are right now, and then where you're planning to go, God willing, with Crosslinks.
Well, hi, Jamie. Hi, everyone. It's really good to be here with you. We are currently in Glasgow. I work for a church here in Glasgow, work with the Tron Church, and we're planning to go to Cyprus, hopefully early next year.
And David and Margarita, what is your link with Cyprus? And I know that there are a couple here, so maybe Margarita, you could start us off on that question.
So I'm actually from Cyprus. I moved to Scotland for university in 2011, met David, we got married in 2015. So yeah, basically Cyprus is my home. So, and I've got a lot of friends and family still back there.
Now, last year, am I right in thinking you managed to get to Cyprus, not once, not twice, but three times? While we were all staycationing, you guys were out in Cyprus three times. Tell us what you did when you went there.
I mean, it was only twice.
Okay, I exaggerate.
One of those was before everything happened. We were in Cyprus in
just before,
in end of January, February, where there were rumours of things kicking off. So we managed to get in a visit then, and a visit later in the year, in August, where things were a bit quieter.
Yeah.
I mean, we have family and friends there, so we were visiting family and friends, as well as talking to various sort of church leaders and things like that that we know well, just about the state of the church in Cyprus.
Yeah. It's interesting for folks watching this, David and Margarita and another couple will be with us on orientation next month. And we haven't actually met in person. So I think this is the first time in the history of Crosslinks that we've ever had candidates come all the way through to the point of orientation. We haven't actually met you in person, but we look forward to orientation next month. But tell us what you plan to do when, God willing, you get to Cyprus next year.
Yeah. We will initially be partnering with a church in Larnaca, which is a city on the south coast in the Greek-speaking section of Cyprus. For the time being, for the first sort of year or so, 6 months to a year, I'll be improving my language. Margarita is fluent in Greek. I'm less fluent. and working with the church there, the Greek Evangelical Church of Cyprus, to basically serving the church in whatever way that I can as my language improves. They do most things in Greek, some things in English, and some things in a mix of both. So as I improve with that, I'll be able to help with.
And what are the sort of particular needs in Cyprus that might be more unique to Cyprus as opposed to Glasgow, Scotland, the UK?
Yeah, only around 1% of Greek Cypriots would say that they're evangelical Christians. The island is mostly Greek Orthodox, historically Greek Orthodox. What that means in practice is that there are lots of people who assume that they're Christians by virtue of their birth, and yet have never heard the gospel actually proclaimed in their own language. They've never had a chance to actually hear about Christ and believe in him. Those that have not benefited from long-term feeding from the word of God. So the need in Cyprus, and I guess it's a similar need to many places across Europe, is more churches that have the faithful teaching of the word of God firmly at the center, proclaiming the gospel of Christ clearly.
Yeah. Well, this is exciting to hear. And it's great because Cyprus is new to Crosslinks. And you know, it's great that we've met you this evening. We're going to meet you in person. But what the next few months are going to look like a time of transition, what do you expect the next few months to look like? What would you like them to look like? What's your prayer for the coming months?
I will continue to work for the Tron for the next few months. So a lot of my day to day is going to be filled with trying to hand over things that I've been heavily involved with for quite a long time. I lead a Farsi speaking ministry at the Tron. So trying to leave that going in good trajectories is going to be a lot of my time. Yeah. At the same time, we're going to be building partnerships with people, hoping to have a good base of people who we can rely on for prayer and for continuing support to really partner with us in this work.
Well, your webpage went live just recently, and I think we've almost been inundated with people who want to get behind you. Now, one of my favourite pictures in the New Testament is Acts chapter 13, 1 to 3. And, you know, Margarita, you're smiling as if you know what's coming, but it's a picture of a church sending out a couple to Cyprus. And I wonder if you can sort of help us think, what would you like? What is your kind of longing for the Tron? And the way in which they might send you. What's your hope for the way they send you off and how that would look in practice?
Yeah, we've been really blessed with a wonderful church family at the Tron. They're a church that are really committed to the same things that we're committed to the local church with the teaching of the Bible at its center, proclaiming Jesus clearly. We know from first-hand experience how generous and prayerful they are towards their mission partners, and so we're very thankful that they will be praying for us regularly at their prayer meetings, helping us financially. We are in a very fortunate position that it's never hard to convince anyone to visit Cyprus. So I imagine we'll be getting plenty of visits from people we know and love. From our church family to come and see the work that God is doing, to hopefully participate in that as well in some ways. We've seen that happen with many of our church mission partners in the past.
And hopefully you'll get to experience it.
Yeah.
Well, as we wrap up, let me just pray for you briefly, and then so that people are aware, there'll be an opportunity to fire questions to me. If you can direct them to me through the chat box, it's a little easier to scoop them up. And in a minute, we'll spotlight the others who've been involved. But let me just pray for David and Margarita. Father God, thank you so much for David, for Margarita, for calling them both to Jesus and for uniting them together in marriage. And we thank you, Lord, for the way in which you've led them to this point, for the ministry you've given them, reaching Farsi-speaking people in Glasgow through the Tron. And for this new chapter, which we entrust to you, these plans for Cyprus, for Larnaca, for the church there, for cultural adjustment, for language learning, for partnership building. And we do thank you so much, Lord, that we read in the New Testament and in the pages of Acts the way in which churches stood with people and gladly sent them out, released them for the ministry of the gospel. And so we pray that that would be David and Margarita's experience, that they would be joyful and thankful in this new chapter, and that you would open doors and take them into places where they couldn't foresee them, take them to a deeper understanding and love for Jesus that they couldn't have imagined. And so we entrust them to you. We thank you for the encouragement of being able to look forward to this chapter of Crosslinks ministry in the future. And we ask that you continue to raise up men and women who will faithfully serve you in the harvest field. So we ask this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.